There is no doubt that when I mention this name, you will know that it is a brand, and this guy has known one of the biggest ways of branding himself. The name is none other than Donald Trump, the 45th president of the United States of America. Every time that name is mentioned, you'll have two groups of people. You'll have those people who hate him, and in equal measure, you'll have those people who love him one way or another. I'm bringing up Donald Trump because I want to share with you one of the mistakes that we normally make with our personal branding. We have been discussing our own personal branding and the mistakes that we do make from time to time. And what we want to do is to make sure that we're not repeating those mistakes. And so, come up, Donald Trump. Let us learn from you. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
Maybe you might want to ask me if I am a supporter of Donald Trump or not. That is totally besides the point. I don't want to discuss that bit, but I could say this, that I do admire some of the ways that this man carries himself around. But one of the things that I saw, there was a documentary that I was watching some days back about how he came to ascend to power. And there's one thing that they mentioned about him, and I can give it a name called tangential. That means that he starts with one thing. There was a time he was given an opportunity to deliver a speech, or say, I think it was 5 minutes, and 1 hour later, if I'm getting my facts correct, he was still rambling on, moving from one subject to another, to another, to another, to another, and really never concentrating on the point. That can be a big problem in terms of anything, by the way. And of course, we are discussing our personal brands here. Let's just back up a little bit and discuss this. That in this day and in this age, it is important for you and I to have a personal brand. We are going to interact, we are going to be engaged, we are going to make a difference, and we are going to make a contribution on the face of the earth commensurate to the effectiveness of our brand, our personal brands. So your brand is important, my brand is important. See, the world is not looking at you from the angle of who you are, what you've been able to accomplish, what are your credentials. The world is looking at you and I from the angle of how much do we care? What is our contribution? What value do we have? What solutions are we bringing? How functional are we in our solutions? It is not looking at us on how big we have studied, how complicated and intricate we are in our academics, and so on and so forth. It's looking at us from the angle of value addition, problem solving, caring, and having compassion on the things that matter to us the most. And guess what? That's where your personal brand comes in. So if you haven't formed a personal brand, it's time for you to consider that. But even as you're forming that personal brand, we've been discussing and saying that there are some mistakes that we normally make. And the very first big mistake that people normally make with their personal brand is to not know that they do have a brand and they are a brand in and of themselves. And you walk around wielding your academic papers or lack of them thereof, thinking that the world is going to interact with you solely because of those academic papers. You fail to understand that the world interacts with you from the angle of perception, how they perceive you, what they perceive you value, what they perceive you solve, what they perceive you care about. That is how they're going to engage with you. People are human. This world is human. It's not mechanical. And so every one of us does have a brand. And the very first mistake people normally make is to think that they are not a brand, that branding is for Nike and for Coca-Cola and for IBM and Apple and Microsoft and all those big corporations, failing to understand that every single individual does have a brand through which they interact with society. You are engaged one way or another in this world through your personal brand. The second mistake that people normally make about their personal branding is that it is as clear as mud. There is no clarity. People cannot identify what you really are doing because you've stretched yourself too thin. You become a Me Too person. You're doing nearly every single detail, and there is no thing that someone can really identify you with. When they say something, your name doesn't pop up because your brand is not clear the way it's supposed to be. The third mistake people normally make with their brands is that it is lousy. There is no touch of excellence. I mean, it's on the cheap. Nothing has been spent in terms of effort, in terms of energy, in terms of money, in terms of professionalism, which is another mistake that I'm going to talk about. And so the brand ends up becoming lousy. And the fourth mistake that we talked about yesterday is that the brand lacks value. People cannot identify what you're really about, what you're really passionate about, what is your value add, what is your solution, what problem it is that you're solving, what it is that you're really mad about that is causing you to rise up to create a brand for the solution. Today, we want to talk about one more thing that is important. You need to understand this as a mistake that people normally make with their brands. And we go back to Donald Trump. Donald Trump is given 5 minutes to speak, and 10 minutes later, 20 minutes later, 30 minutes later, he is still speaking. And his speech is moving from one point to another point to another point until he's just veered off the topic, so much so that someone does not understand what exactly it is that he was talking about. The same thing we normally have with the president of Uganda. Very comical, very amiable, very astute in his communication, but he is almost always gets caught, you know, moving away from the main topic to examples and examples, and then the example comes with another example and so on, and then he comes back to the topic. That is what we call tangential disorder. Moving from one tangent to another tangent to another tangent until the main point is lost. And that's the problem that people normally make with their personal brands. It is what we call broken focus. If I wanted to take you out, if I wanted to really mess you up, I would break your focus. See, if you see someone who is focused and they are moving on in one direction, one straight direction, that is someone who is going to make progress over a long period of time. But if you stop this person and break their focus, guess what? What you've broken is their momentum. And momentum and consistency, which is something I'm going to talk about tomorrow, is absolutely important when it comes to your personal branding. But now broken focus is a break your focus and you start focusing on something else. In other words, you drop what it is that you're doing yesterday, what is it that you've been doing the past 5 years, you're no longer identified with it. And let me just stop here for a minute and explain. At times, brands normally branch out and have other things that they normally do. but they never veer off from the main tangent, the main target, the main line of activity. They never really move away from it completely. See, Apple starts as a products machine, a products company, creating machines that solve problems, help people to make work life easier. And they start developing these iPods and iPhones and so on, but they have never really veered off from the main thing, the main brand, creating great products for people. That is where the problem can be. A mistake where you break your focus. See, someone like Nokia breaks their focus. Someone like Motorola breaks their focus, and they start doing things that really do not matter. One of the greatest mistakes that you can do with your personal brand is to break your focus. See, Tony Robbins once said that the reason as to why very many people are not successful is because they meddle a lot. Their hands are on this thing, and they do it for 2 weeks, and they do it for 2 years, and then they become dissatisfied, or they become discontent, or whatever it is, they give up, and they see maybe the money is not in there, and they stop it, and they break their focus, and then they go and start something else. They start meddling in it, and they're meddling in it for 1 year, and then they break their focus, and they go to something else. They start meddling in it and meddling in it, they break their focus, and all along, if you look at their life, the cross-section of their life is just littered with broken focus. Focus broken after focus broken after focus broken. At the end of the day, there is absolutely nothing important or nothing that stands out in terms of a brand to identify the human being. Reason as to why many people are not successful is because they meddle a lot. They do not have a single thing that they can dedicate their lives to and known for it. And where is the problem? The problem, for the most part, begins with the beginning. I normally say that start with something worth finishing and finish it. The problem, people normally start branding themselves unconsciously by pursuing after things from which they can gain, instead of focusing on something through which they can have people benefit and add value and add their contribution on the face of the earth. And at the end of the day, you are able to stick with that for the long haul. But if you start something just for the sake of starting, chances are that when push comes to shove, where the rubber meets the road, when a problem comes, when there is no strong why, there's no strong reason, there's no strong purpose for which you began that thing, you are going to bench it. There is no strong energy of conviction to continue with it. See, conviction is a very powerful force. So if you do not want your focus to be broken, make sure that the conviction for the brand conviction is there. Brand conviction is something that someone can be able to see, not something that someone can be able to borrow, not something that someone can be able to copy and paste. Brand conviction is where you go into your own heart, into your own spirit, and you ask questions like, what matters the most? What is the most important thing? If I was to spend the rest of my life doing it and everything else remains constant, what would it be? So that is where the answer is supposed to come from, and when that answer comes, that's where you're supposed to dedicate your life on. But chances are that if you do everything from the point of view of what you're going to gain out of it, or from this short-termism aspect, where you don't care about other people, you don't care about the difference you're making, you don't care about the problems you're solving, you don't care about the solutions you're bringing to the face of the earth, chances are that when push comes to shove, when a problem comes, you're going to scatter, you're going to skedaddle, and you're going to leave the so-called brand on its own. And if you look at people's lives, you will see what I'm talking about. We used to identify people with something, and then all of a sudden, they are no longer doing that. I have a friend of mine who, for years on end, if you go to his Facebook page, I worked with him actually, he was my assistant at some point in time. But if you go to his social media, his Instagram, his Facebook and so on, he's always talking about coffee. This guy comes from a family that cherishes coffee, and so he moved on to the United States of America, and even there, he's page and his work is about coffee, it's about seeds, it's about the aroma. I mean, that's his brand. He's branding himself or branding his life and the solution around coffee. So the fifth worst mistake that you can be able to make that causes your brand to be lousy, it is broken focus. To be intentional means you need to have a plan to daily grow that brand and never veering off from it. See, I normally talk about purpose, I talk about productivity, and I talk about resilience, and probably there has been no direct money out of this thing for quite a number of years, maybe a decade down the line. But it will be a very interesting thing later on if you tuned into Life Signatures Radio and what you're hearing is gossip, or you're hearing about fashion trends, you're hearing about politics. That will be broken focus. Those things have their place in other people's lives, other people's brands, but they don't have a place in my brand. The secret of success is concentration. The cause of failure is broken focus. That's what my mentor, Mike Murdock, normally talks about. So if you want to build a great brand, do not break your focus. Stay on course. Come rain, come shine. Find that thing which is worth doing, what matters the most to you, and stick to it with laser-like focus. Tomorrow we'll discuss something else. Until then, bye-bye. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who was graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.